a monolithic structure definitely gives you protection, no questions about that. And we also argued that it's performant because of the fact that border crossings are minimized and loss of locality is minimized and sources of copying overhead are minimized. All of that add up to giving good performance for a monolithic structure. On the other hand, it's not easily extensible. Any change to the operating system would require rebuilding the monolithic structure with the changed characteristic of the system service. So one size fits all is what you get with a monolithic structure. A DOS-like structure is performant because there is no separation between the application and the operating system, and therefore an application can execute system services at the same speed as it would execute a procedure call that is part of that application itself. And it is also easily extensible because you can build new versions of system service to cater to the needs of specific applications. But on the other hand, it fails on the safety attribute because there is no boundary separating the kernel from the user space. A microkernel-based operating system also pays attention to protection because it makes sure that the applications and the servers are in distinct hardware address spaces separated from the microkernel itself. And it is also easily extensible because you can have different servers that provide the same service but differently to cater to the needs of the application. But it may have performance loss because of the need for so many border crossings that might be needed to go between applications and the server processes. Having said that, I want to give a note of caution. On the surface, it may appear that the microkernel-based approach may not be performant because of the potential for frequent border crossings. I'll have a surprise for you on this aspect when we discuss the L3 microkernel later on in this course module, where it is shown that a microkernel can be made performant by careful implementation. That's the key. I'll leave you with that thought, but we'll come back to a microkernel-based design using L3 later on.